Hello and welcome to the first round of the 2016 ACU Sprint Championship at Rogers Hill Raceway. The event is organised by Fast Eddy Racing, and we hope to have a word with Fast Eddy himself now.
Bob, we're at Rogers Hill Raceway, round one of the ACU GBXC British Sprint Championship. We've got a lot in store. We've got some great riders in Championship Expert and Clubman.
Right.
And we're following that up with the vets, the sportsmen and the youth class, and a few ladies once they've decided what class they want to be in.
Now we've got 2 days of racing and we've got two courses, isn't there?
That's it, Bob. Yeah, 2 days of racing, two tests.
Yep.
MX test and an Enduro stroke extreme test. We're hoping to give the riders roughly about 10 minutes of combined test times per lap. And we're going for 6 time tests on each for them as well.
And this is the first round of a 4-round series?
First round of a 4-round, all to count.
Right.
Entry was set at 120. We've managed to reach that, so that was great news. Obviously starting down south with hopefully better weather, but hey, as long as it's dry, we're not complaining.
It's a little bit cool, but...
It's cool to say the least, but yeah, that's the main thing, Bob. So yeah.
Good. Well, we're all looking forward to it, and there's a huge crowd of people ready to sign on, so... Let's see where we go from here.
That's it. We'll hope you guys catch plenty of action. I'm sure you will.
Well done, Paul.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Okay, well, we're with Steve Holcomb. Good result for you last week at 2 weeks ago, the first round of the British.
You know, the result for me for the start of the year at Yorkshire was really good. You know, it's always great to sort of win both days. You know, I feel like my preparations are coming along good now, and you know, we're here for a good bit of training. It's still a couple of weeks out from the first race in Morocco, so it's all going to plan.
Great. Well, you've said everything that needs to be said. I'm going to wish you good luck.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Cheers.
Well, we're with Brad Freeman, and Brad's just been off for a year with a knee injury?
An ankle injury. Oh. Right ankle injury, yep. So right ankle ligament injury. So been out for kind of a year, so just coming back this year and just feeling good now. So.
And you had a great start at the Europeans last weekend.
Yeah, no, really good weekend. My first time racing abroad in kind of, I think about 18 months really, so you know, I was really nervous for the event. Steady day on Saturday, second overall, and then I managed to win it overall on a Sunday to get the overall for the weekend, so couldn't have asked for a better start to the year really.
Yeah, I noticed you're growing a moustache.
Yeah, no, I'm trying to catch you up, aren't I?
Well, I think that's great, because a lot of the boys concentrate too much on the biking and don't have a hobby, so growing a moustache, fantastic.
That's exactly it.
Hopefully, you'll have a great day.
Brilliant, thanks a lot.
Right, well, with Daryl Bolter from KTM UK, and you had a good ride at Hemsley.
Yeah, it was all right, you know. For a championship rider, the course I don't think was too bad. It was the majority that sort of were struggling, and it was just unlucky with the weather and things. For me personally, I had a great round, really. It was a tough round, everybody was struggling.
That's it.
And I just kept plodding on and come away with a class win, which is the goal for this year, to win the class. And a sixth and an eighth overall, so yeah overall pleased. I've got more to give, so I'm looking forward to the next one.
You're looking forward to the rest of the series?
Looking forward to the rest of the series, and then obviously we're doing the sprint series with Paul as well. I mean, you can't beat, you've only got to come here and look at the event and see the effort that's gone in, and you know, the tests themselves look like sort of European style tests. They're just really, really good, so I'm really excited about today.
That's it. Any other plans apart from the sprint and the BEC?
I've got the sprint, the BEC, Welsh today. I'd like to have a crack at Western again.
How many times have you won the Welsh today?
I think, I'm not 100% sure, but it's about five or six, I think. I'm just behind AD Smith. AD Smith's got one more win than me.
Brilliant.
So I'm chasing that one. I'm not quite up to sort of Geraint Jones yet.
Yeah, well, good luck today. I think, look forward to the day.
Thank you very much.
All the best, Al.
Cheers.
With Dan Hall and Bradley King and Craig Regman, and we're having a little presentation for the Rogers Hill Raceway and Dorset Enduro Winter Warmer Series, which was won by Bradley King.
Yeah, so we'd just like to congratulate Bradley on a good performance, consistency throughout the whole series, and just to thank all the other riders that participated and made the series a success.
I'd like to thank the guys for organising some great events. It's good to have some a proper series down our way now. I really enjoyed it. Looking forward to next season, and hopefully have some time card events coming down our way as well.
I think there is a time card to come on, can you?
We're hoping, Dorset Police are hoping to run a time card event on the 1st of May.
1st of May?
Bovington, absolutely.
Sounds great. Would you like to do the presentation?
Congratulations, Bradley.
Thank you very much.
And now we're with Charlie Evans from Land Idlois, who's riding for the new Yamaha Off-Road Experience team. How's that working out for you, Charlie?
Yeah, it's going well so far. We haven't done an awful lot of testing yet, as I've been busy with the family, but it's coming well now. Yeah. Getting a bit of time and the weather's getting better, so we're getting on with a new bike.
Motocross last weekend?
Yeah, did a local motocross last weekend, a good bit of practice for the sprints and also the special tests on the Enduros, so going to try and keep a few of those going.
That's it. And the family working out all right?
So far, so good. I don't want to talk too early yet, but she's sleeping all right. So.
Well done. Well done. New father.
Thank you very much.
Good luck, Charlie.
Thank you, Bob.
Oh,
Well, the opening day of the 2016 ACU Sprint Championship has been a tremendous battle between Brad Freeman and Steve Holcomb. Brad has come out the overall winner. Steve was second. Tom Sager was third. Daryl Boulder was fourth. And Jack Edmondson was fifth. In the experts class, Alex Walton was the winner. Tom Elwood second and Brad King third. The veterans were Mark Hawkins, Andy Daniels and Danny Hall, the local lad. In the clubman class, Fred Adams was the winner, Brad Rowlands was second and Jack Nixie was third. The ladies class was Kate Smith and the youth winner was Harry Edmondson, Henry Yardley was second and Jake James was third. It was a tremendous day. I hope you enjoy the footage. We're now going into the second day. It's a 9 o'clock start. It's going to be great. Well, we're with Tom Sager on Sunday morning. Good race yesterday?
Yeah, not too bad. I had a bit of a slow start, as you can probably see on the results. But yeah, it was a steady day. Had some stuff that I wanted to try. We haven't got a lot of spares here for the bikes and stuff. We've left the van out in France at the factory between the two Europeans rather than bringing it home. So I'm actually currently on the practice bike this weekend.
Big 450?
Yeah, big 450, which is incredibly light as well. It's quite an interesting bike this year, actually. It's taking a bit of getting used to. Obviously, this is only the third race that I've actually raced the bike. So still everything's a little bit new. Luckily, after France next weekend, we've got a bit of a break. So we can try some different things and... you know, obviously practicing through the winter, you can try all sorts of different things, yeah. And you know, it's never like doing a race. So yeah, we've got a lot of things to do, a lot of things to test now in April, and hopefully we come back to the next round of the Sprint Championship in, I think it's May, fighting fit, and hopefully we can start pushing some better times out.
Yeah, well, you say it was a very light bike because you did very well on the motocross test, but when you got to the enduro test, you did even better.
Well, as it was, like, even back on the other bikes I rode, you know, I was always very much, I was always better on the harder stuff. The motocross test was always my downfall because obviously, that's where I didn't come from, you know. But, it was obviously getting into it as well for the day. Hopefully this morning will be a little bit different. Hopefully I can get onto the motocross test and start a little bit stronger. Yesterday morning we lost a lot of time in the first test because I haven't really walked the track and stuff. So, been a bit of a mixed weekend, really. You know, at the next round we'll have a lot more time on our hands, go up to the race and walk it, but we're still in early days with the bike as well, so we can't expect too much. But I think a third place yesterday was ample. It was good. I'm happy with my result, and you know, there's a lot of quick young lads out there now.
That's
and
right.
I'm one of the veterans, and all we can do now is keep fighting and trying to get that top place.
Well, I think an old veteran did quite well at the Italian round last week, wasn't it? You come won your class?
Yeah, I won my class. Had a sixth and a third overall, which I was quite pleased with. I was battling with lads that I battled with last year, and I was still there or thereabouts on a new bike, so I can't really complain. We know that we've still got the speed. It's just about me and the bike just finding that last sort of 10% gelling, you know. And as I said, with the parts that we're going to change in the next couple of months and try and get the bike to work better for me, really. Yeah. The bike as a standard bike is fantastic, and I'm not just saying that because I'm on one. You know, I've been on the bike now since like November, have had no problems, everything seems to be good, and you know, we're just trying to push the brand and see where we can go with it.
And the sun is coming out, so good luck for today, Tom.
Thanks very much. Cheers.
Great. Yesterday was a great day for you, Brad. You won.
Yeah, managed to get the overall win from Steve Holcomb and Daryl Bolt third. Couldn't have asked for a better day, really. Me and Steve were battling all day. And that's how you want to see racing, really. When people are watching it and you're in the race, that's how you want it, nice and close.
Yeah, it was fantastic. And how many motos do you think you won?
I won 10 out of 12 tests. Yep. Steve won the first test on both tracks and I won the others. But the margin of victory was only less than 5 seconds. Yep. Over the whole day, so it's incredible, really. We were going within half a second of each other on every sort of every test, so that's how you want the racing, you know. It was good.
I noticed I was at the fourth moto at the extreme on the enduro test. I was at the top of the quarry and I noticed you went for a five there was
nearly went back down. but it was quite tricky that hill. Everyone was really nervous before we got there. But I was first at it, and I think everyone had a bit of a sigh of relief when I managed to get up it. But no, it turned out well.
Yeah. Great. Well, that's good luck for today, and I hope you do the best.
Yeah, brilliant. Thanks a lot.
There was a tremendous battle between Steve Holcomb and Brad Freeman, with Brad setting the fastest times in 10 out of the 12 heats on Saturday, before Steve came back on Sunday to clinch the overall by 5 seconds. 5 seconds after 24 heats. Jack Edmondson crashed in his first heat on Saturday, but he clawed his way back to finish 5th. On Sunday, he was much more consistent and got a well-deserved third step on the podium. Super consistency Darrell Bolter finished 3rd on Saturday and 4th on Sunday. Tom Sager was throwing his new shirt around like a 125, although it was a 450, and he finished 3rd on Saturday and 5th on Sunday. Well, it's been a fantastic weekend here at Rogers Hill Raceway in Dorset for the opening round of the 2016 ACU Sprint Championship, organised by Fast Eddy Racing. They've done a fantastic job. It's been very cold, biting north wind, but the competition has been red hot.